clicked it.
All right, here we go.
All right. Presentation mode. And that is...
Timer will be on the TV.
Wait, go back. Okay, so our topic was water pollution, and specifically in the Ohio River, because it has been an ongoing problem for a long time, and we think from the results that we found that if we don't do something about it, then it will reach in a limit that cannot be undone. So currently there's chemicals being put into the Ohio River. It's just like a base of what is happening right now. And because of that, it's causing animals to get sick, ecosystems to suffer, and treatment bills to rise in companies local around the Ohio River area. And there are some warning signs that are starting to take its effect on the communities around the Ohio River. Since the Ohio River is a water source for over 3 million people, water pollution is not helping the population. It's suffering the communities. So, an interesting fact is the Ohio River was ranked the most polluted body of water in the United States for the 7th year in a row this year. So that just shows that the water pollution is staying at a constant rate. So we're not doing anything to help it. And yeah. So another interesting fact is in 2013, 23 million pounds of chemicals was dumped into the Ohio River. So... okay, now play this video. This is a really serious video, guys. Don't laugh. Just kidding, it's pretty ridiculous, but it's a little skit that we made of what's happening, so there you go. Turn the volume. We spent a lot of time on this.
Hello! My name is Ohio River. Hello. My name is Water Pollution.
As you can see, the Ohio River is running away from the water pollution. That would be better than a regular video. So. Okay, next one. So, some people might be saying, who cares? Not bothering me. Well, excess chemicals causes what's known as algae blooms. Now, does anyone know what an algae bloom is? No. Okay. So, an algae bloom, to summarize it up, it's basically a floating poisonous organism that is formed from excess chemicals being wasted into the Ohio River. And algae blooms are growing because of the excess chemicals being wasted into the Ohio River. And because algae blooms are growing, Fish are dying, we're getting sick, and ecosystems are being damaged. And this is just kind of a connection to show you, like, how this can, like, come back to us. When the fish are poisoned by drinking the water that is infected with algae blooms, then the predators get poisoned because they eat their prey. Well, then we ingest them whenever we buy them from local stores, and we get sick as well. So now we're to the point where some people are saying it doesn't involve me. Well, water treatment bills are increasing because of the algae blooms growing in population. So the quality of area is decreasing. There is health hazards for swimmers in the summers, and there is changes in the communities.
So this is what people are doing. Some companies that are trying to lower the treatments for that are being put into the Ohio River. But not everybody's going to help, and the river won't like get any better. It's just going to maintain the same level.
So the third solution that scientists are trying to do is reducing nutrient deposition, which, like we talked about earlier, nutrient deposition is just excess chemicals from companies around the Ohio River. So a strength of that would be A strength of that is less trash dumped in the Ohio River. Everyone can help, and they can make money.
Wait, that was wrong. I think I did something
wrong.
Yeah, I did. Oops.
Okay, that was for recycling. Now we're at reducing nutrient deposition. Go to the strengths. The strength of that would be fewer algae blooms, less money spent on treatment, and ecosystems will thrive again. But a weakness of that would be, where would all the excess waste go? You're kind of leaving the companies in the dust because they don't have anywhere to put their waste now. Well, if you're trying to reduce the chemicals, then where would they put it? So that could lead to possible land pollution. Now, the last one scientists are trying to do is water detection, and basically it is a sensory machine that can detect changes in water quality level, and a strength of that is it can detect changes before it gets worse. It can see, like, invisible pollution almost, like the chemicals that you don't normally see on a regular basis, and it's automatic. But a weakness of that is it could mess with the ecosystem because, for instance, birds may think it's food because it's not big enough, and they'll think it's food, and then they can't digest it, so it'll end up killing wildlife. So this is our solution.
This is the, like, what it looks like, and this is, like, it's big enough where you can see it's touching the land. The chemical water comes through here in the openings, at 1, 2, and 3 openings, and it comes in and it filters through here.
And you use natural filters,
yeah,
like carbon and just natural filters.
And then it comes out 4 and 5 with clean water. And this is, this means it's retractable, so that when boats come, they can just retract the arms and the boats can come through. It combines problems of, like, animals thinking it's food. It reduces algae blooms.
and filters the water. It's automatic. It's made from recyclables like aluminum, plastic, glass, like cans and stuff like that. And it allows boats to pass through, and it's environmentally safe.
So the last like discussion question that we're supposed to ask you guys is, why do you think that we did not act upon this faster? Why do you think that we let it grow to what it is today and still, like, not doing anything about it? What do you guys think? Question is, why do you think we did not act upon this faster? Because if the water pollution levels stay the same as they are today, we could end up with an environment like that and just not quality at all.
I saw Carly's my first.
Okay, Carly.
I think honestly it's just because it hasn't affected enough people yet, so they're just, like you said, they're like, who cares, it's not affecting me.
Mm-hmm.
I agree with her, because like you said earlier in the presentation, like, people are not affected by this, they're not getting anything about it.
Mm-hmm.
I know that I didn't know all about this before you guys did your presentation, so maybe the people who don't know about this.
Yeah.
Could have been like whenever earlier when it wasn't as big of a problem, they didn't think it would have been gotten as big,
mm-hmm.
but yet it has. It's still bad.
I can understand this has been here for a long time, so it's probably because we didn't have the technology
mm-hmm.
to do this.
Like, I agree with, like, Kaden and Carly, like, about how most people probably are, like, it doesn't matter to me because I'm not the one dealing with it and it doesn't affect me. Like, I think, I also, like, have, like, a finger on motives, like, or, like, what they might be raised. Like, some people, most people probably don't know about it. Like, I think when all the chemicals are spilled into the Ohio River, that, like, some people don't know that that's happening. Like, they're just in it's a normal.
Yeah, I agree with most of you. I'm going to, like, connect it to Boyan Slat. I think that's his name. Remember whenever he made that brilliant idea on how to reduce the trash in the ocean? Well, if someone steps out and does make a difference, then people will know about it and will make a change and finally, like, protect the future almost. So that's it. Anyone have any questions? Again.
How long has this been going on for?
Well, it's been going on. It's always kind of been going on, but just recently there has been like a few companies who have been like dumping millions of waste into the river. For no reason. They just don't have anywhere to go, so they dump it there. Okay. You have another
question that has an effect on your question. I think it's just the people who are polluting the waters have been so good at hiding it for so long,
mm-hmm.
and it's just now starting to show up. So that's probably a big part of it.
Okay.
Logan?
If people of businesses are doing this, why are they not fine?
If people.
First of all, it's illegal.
Restate your question again.
What?
Can you restate your question?
Alright, so if you said that you know that said earlier to my question that you businesses are dumping this into the ocean, lake, but it's most likely illegal to do that, I'm pretty sure. Are they not fined or anything?
No. They companies have been like asking for more like reliability to dump more than they are now. So since they're not giving the okay, they are still doing the same thing, which is not helping anything still. Okay.
Also, got your, like, because you might go back to your picture or whatever. What? You said that it'll move some of the boats coming, but water's still pushing with the boats. So how's that getting clean still? It's still pretty. The boats pass through, the chemicals are still coming.
The idea of our solution was to reduce chemical flowing through the river. It's not designed to extravate, like, all of the chemicals flowing through the Ohio River, just, like, reduce to what it is now. Because if you don't make a small change, then it's going to keep escalating to a larger level.
So what you're saying is there's still chemicals in the water still, right?
Yes, there will and there always will be, but we can't, the only thing we can do is just try to come up with as much as we can to reduce it to a lower level. Right now, I don't really think anyone...
So, good questions, good answers. I think that makes sense. It's not